morning, everyone. I'll be making forward-looking statements, and John's already done half my speech for me. So, yes, if those of you who don't know me, I'm Ken McNaughton. I did spend 20 years at Silver Standard. I still work with Pretium as well. So, you know, and in those years of discovery and moving companies forward, we've managed, or my technical ability was to drill off 2 billion ounces of silver for Silver Standard and 15, 20 million ounces of gold. So, you know, as a team, and I have a lot of them with me at Camino, you know, we know how to recognize opportunities. We know, once we get it, how to advance it and get the most value out of it. And so today I am talking about our Mina Justa project. It's a new discovery. We optioned the ground last May. We signed the deal in July. And since July, we've completed a couple rounds of geophysics, geology, permitting, financing. So it's a project that's got a lot of momentum, which is something we really like. You can see from this, we're nicely located near the coast, about an 8-hour drive south of Lima, on the Pan American Highway. We're 15 kilometers from the coast. Chala, you may have heard of it. There's a number of custom mills in there, including Inca One. So we've got a good location with great access and a mining-oriented community. The thing that I'd like you to take away from this talk right now is, when we started there was a couple of outcrops with good copper and some indications of alteration. And what we've been able to do is, there's two trends there. The northern one, where we're working, it's 6 kilometers long, and everywhere we break rock, we start finding copper. So that tells us we've got a significant system on a proven trend. I should have shown you Mina Justa. It's 100 kilometers away. So we've got our exploration model that we can work from. But along that northern trend where we've been focusing, we keep everything that we saw when we were there is still there as a primary target. And in fact, we've enhanced it with more geophysics and then drilling. And in fact, where we drilled, let's get that to go. Hang on, there we go. So this was the outcrop that we walked up to. This is actually from my property review back in May. And what you're looking at is the face of Adriana. Nice copper mineralization on the outcrop's 150 by 75 meters. We picked drill targets last July, and we permitted those drill targets, and we set the drill up on those platforms. So that's been the consistency of this project, and so it's moved along quickly. Here we are drilling. For those of you that know geology, it's an IOCG, so iron oxide, copper, gold. There's a structural component controlling the mineralization. There's also some bedding and lithologic controls. And the discovery hole that we made, hole one went in underneath the mineralization. Hole two, which swings off to the right, was the one that cut the oxide mineralization and then ended up deeper down. Here we go. Plan view, see if I can work this. Yeah. So hole two, just so I'll just shout, hole two collared in. This is that zone that we were all looking at. So big area, lots of copper. Then we came down and we ended up intersecting some sulfide mineralization, which eventually the hole was stopped in a fault. So we had our zone. We came over, we did hole four. The zone that we're looking for is deeper than we expected, but the hole's there. We're going to try and extend it. And then we came in. So with our program, really what we wanted to do, we did our raise. We did a $2 million financing in February. We wanted to do proof of concept with this program. So we came in with an RC drill, relatively cheap, gets us good information. We didn't like how the drill was performing, and given the discovery, we decided to suspend the program. And we need better geology, so we'll be starting again with a diamond drill here shortly. And I'll just walk you quickly through the sections. There's nothing terribly technical here. We're in a volcanic package, and in essence, we come down through some copper oxides, which is our surface discovery, and then we came into this magnetite zone in hole one, which we didn't appreciate it as much as we should have. Hole four is one that went off and tested some more oxide. And, but, let's do this. Very good. So hole two is the one that really got the market excited and created all that volume. And basically, again, we cut through our oxide mineralization up top. We came down through this magnetite zone, and we were heading over towards an IP anomaly. So it wasn't just fortuitous. We were headed over to a target. And then what we ended up coming in is, as we came out the bottom of the magnetite, we started seeing a bit of overlap with copper oxides. And then as soon, right at the bottom of the magnetite zone, the grades jump up to 2 to 3%. So all of a sudden, we had a very large, very high-grade anomaly coming out, 106 meters of 1.3, and within that, this 38 meters of plus 2% copper, and then a bit of silver with it. There's no gold in this system. I can bore you with details, but trust me, there's no gold. And that's ultimate end, isn't it? So what we've got is we've got that, and as I said, hole four came down through the same stratigraphy. We did see some oxide zones. And as soon as we hit the top of the magnetite zone, we knew, okay, we're in the system, and there's some markers in here that were showing up over here. So we're really confident it's the same zone. Unfortunately, we got down to the depth limits of the drill, and as soon as we hit there, I pegged we'd start seeing copper at 390, but we could only drill to 360. So unfortunately, you know, there's still it's still sitting out there with a question mark, but not the first thing we'll do. We'll with a diamond drill, we'll set up over here and we'll come down and drill and twin this hole. We want to get that geology, but we will try to get back down this hole and finish that off. Now, we'll just go quickly. So Adriana is one zone, but if you think back to that earlier slide, we actually have six or seven zones on that one northern trend. And then we've got the southern trend as well that had historical production on it, high grades, good widths. So everything about this project is stacking up to look like Mina Justa. Mina Justa, you know, their resource there, 370 million tons of 0.7. We're seeing all those dynamics here. We're seeing the copper grades. We're seeing the plethora of showings that's kind of the size potential that this project has. This is absolutely green fields. There'd never been a drill hole here. There'd been a few geos on it, but never done a deal. So it's absolutely grassroots. It's where I like to be in, because I don't believe in optionality. I believe that projects are projects or they're not. So if you can't make it work, it's never going to work in the future. So we like this, and it's got the potential, and with the funding we just completed, we'll be ready to go and move forward the project. Now, so Kati is the next zone. We're going to drill that as well on this round. It's a kilometer from Adriana. As I spoke to, Ataho, there's some historical. That's on the southern trend. And that's it.
Thank you, Ken. And your market cap's now, what, $50, $60 million?